Now, in an editorial, Charlie Hebdo said the caricatures now belong to history. But Pakistan has condemned the move, saying it offends billions of Muslims. Others have defended the right to freedom of expression. Well, one of them is Andrew Copson. He's the president of Humanist International, which leads a campaign to repeal laws against blasphemy around the world.
Well, every human being, as far as we're concerned and as far as the international human rights treaties are concerned, has the right to freedom of expression. And that right to freedom of expression can only be limited in the interests of other people if those other people would suffer harm. So although there may be a case in any liberal democracy that abides by human rights for limiting things like hate speech or incitement to violence, there's never any cause to censor or to criminalise expressions of ridicule or debate, whether academic or in popular circles. And that's why blasphemy laws offend against that principle, which is a key principle for progress and modern societies.
It is a key principle, but shouldn't we, you know, OK, let's accept we have these rights enshrined by laws, but shouldn't we exercise those rights responsibly?
Absolutely. People who choose not to give offence to others are perfectly within their rights to choose not to give offence. I don't go around myself on a daily basis trying to offend, trying my best to offend everyone that I meet. But if you want to criticise an idea, and religions in particular are very strong ideas which have a huge sway over people's lives, which affect the lives of billions of people globally, if you want to criticise ideas, you should be able to do so. And criticism of ideas, debate about ideas, even mockery and ridicule of ideas is one of the ways that we've made progress over the centuries as human beings, and that's essential. I think one of the unfortunate things about the attack on Charlie Hebdo and other attacks that have been made both in Europe and around the world is that to some extent they have succeeded. And people are more likely now to censor themselves. We saw in the coverage of the Charlie Hebdo murders that many news outlets censored their own coverage of the cartoons that had provoked the atrocity. In my view, they're wrong to do so, because by silencing themselves and not reporting the cartoons that actually caused the murders, they gave free license to many very hostile actors around the world who published fake cartoons, worse cartoons than the ones that were actually published, and whipped up hysteria and resentment and hostility and violence